Well, now you know we're talking about Greta Thunberg, the 18-year-old climate activist. But what we are not talking about today is how she's too young, or how she doesn't know enough about the issues she's so passionate about, or how she's making the adults uncomfortable. We are not talking about her age, her rage, or any of those things that you might have heard against Greta till now. In fact, we are not talking against Greta at all. I truly feel that Greta in the last couple of years has arguably done more as a teen climate activist than several other hoity-toity world leaders with all their influence and power and resources and experience. Greta spoke and the world had to listen. A 15-year-old protested outside her school, and her protest was so powerful that school children across the globe, from Sweden to the US and UK and Japan and India, protested with her. She said the adults have stolen her dreams and her childhood and her future. She protested outside her school. She protested for children across the globe. And this is what we're here to talk about today. When Greta spoke of the futures and dreams and hopes of children across the globe, she perhaps overlooked the futures of children in developing countries like India. Fridays for Future and School Strike for Climate have gained prominence in urban Indian schools. They are powerful movements. They're aimed at pressuring the governments of the world into meeting carbon emissions targets. And these have to be met now. There is no time. We need to act now. We can't plan anymore. We can't think and set net zero targets because all of that is pointless. We need to act immediately.
We must find a smooth transition towards a low carbon economy. There is no planet B. There is no planet blah, 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 net zero by 2050, blah, 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 net zero, blah, 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 climate neutral, blah, blah, blah.
But hold on a minute here. Let's press pause. For a second, let's assume that we do act immediately. We do not take the time we need to transition slowly. Considering the trillions of dollars that would be needed and technology that we need and clearly don't have, we would be left with lakhs of homes with no electricity, lakhs of children who cannot go to school because schools are too far, or who have to walk to school every day for kilometers. They would be left on the deprived end of the digital divide, while the internet opens up new opportunities for the rest of the world. We would be left with higher food insecurity in a country where 38% children under the age of 5 are malnourished. And while the children in the first world countries would still be left with their privileges, for our children, this would mean food insecurity, malnutrition, no electricity, drop of income for many, making schools a luxury, taking away their right to education. And here, if one argues, if there is no air to breathe and floods washing away communities, what good are schools? We hear you. But the point is, you cannot take away children's right to live a wholesome life that most in Greta's part of the world are living and have been living for decades now. But lakhs of our children in our countries or generations before them have never experienced till today. Will it then be fair to ask these children to give up on the electricity they never had or access to the education they rightfully deserve? To ensure that this does not happen to our children and their futures, it is imperative that we do not act in haste, and definitely not in the same capacity as the developed countries. We think, we focus on just transition. We ensure that the cost of green is not too heavy on our children. This is not to delegitimize Greta or undermine her efforts or efforts of thousands of children who have joined her protests. But in essence, what Greta wants from developing countries seems to sound very close to what the developed world has been pushing us towards all this while. It is not a level playing field. It is not fair. And it is, of course, entirely the responsibility of our government to ensure that they protect the futures of our children at all costs. And there are no doubts that they have also failed to ensure this in its entirety so far. But it is also equally the responsibility of the United Global Forces. And yours too, Greta, every time you take the stage to speak for the children across the globe.
We are truthful, unafraid, and independent because of you. Now you can help our reporting from the ground. Go to thequinn.com, click Become a Member tab, choose a plan, and pay. Because the truth is worth it.